I will now request founder, CEO and editor-in-chief of IndianTelevision.com group, Mr. Anil Wanvari, to come on the dais to light the lamp and declare Vidnet 2019 open.
Yeah, I'll be lighting the lamp in a few minutes. Before I just want to share a few words with the audience. Welcome to Vidnet 2019. This is not our summit. It's not IndianTelevision.com's summit and get-together. It is your summit. It is your get-together. All of you all who are involved in the OTT ecosystem or want to be involved in the OTT ecosystem. It's very interestingly poised. You know, the subscription model needs fixing as far as OTT is concerned. My colleagues who are running the OTTs will, bear with me on this. The world's largest OTT service, Netflix, has kind of decided that $9.99 doesn't work in India. So they've gone towards $1.99 for mobile phones only. And more than that, very recently, they decided to give away the first episode of Bad Blood as a sampling for free. I don't know if this is a precursor of further things to come where possibly will Netflix go the award way. They swore they wouldn't change prices, but they have changed prices for India, and they haven't managed to get the traction that they would like to. Ted Sarandos and Reed Hastings talk about getting the next 100 million subs out of India because traditional markets are slowing down. The US has actually lost some subscribers. So will they get the 100 million from India? How will they get the 100 million? Because at the end of the day, shareholders are watching, debtors are watching, the debt pile is, building up. So as far as Hotstar goes, it gets spikes during cricket tournaments. Similarly with Sony Live, whenever there's a good hot cricket property, of course they get consistent viewership also, but that's on the award side. Uday may disagree with me, Uday Sodhi, and so may the folks from Hotstar. But there are challenges in the subscription side. Are Indians ready to pay for consuming content? That's something we'll discover as time goes by. Most of the platforms have below sub double digit million subscribers. I mean, is that a large market enough for a country like India where we have a billion plus population? We have close to 200 million television subscribers. These are, who are churning out tens of thousands of crores for the sector every year. Those are questions the OTT sector has to, ponder over. However, the rollout of OTT services continues unabated. Questions that need asking are, how long will the customer acquisition phase by OTT platforms continue? How long can they continue acquiring customers, investing in acquiring customers? How long can they continue to invest in content which is supposed to be premium and original? Will the investment plan see extensions? That means if they've said 7 years, 3 years, 5 years, will they go to 10 years? It happened with television initially that the plans had to be extended, the investment plans. Will advertisers respond to the AVOD model as much as they've done to YouTube and other social media platforms? Most of the money is going towards these outlets. Advertising spends are going towards these outlets. The challenges are there, of course. Is the telco bundling model the only way to get the large number of subscribers as far as the OTT platforms are concerned? Or are there other ways of acquiring customers too? Is partnering with cable TV networks, they're doing that, some of it, with DTH platforms. Are there new ways of acquiring customers? Can the brand have enough appeal to get customers beyond being bundled with other services? Then the content side. Are these premium originals where you have profanities, you have dark shows, are they the only way to, are they going to go beyond the premium audiences? Do these guys want to get, will they have to move towards more massy-based shows rather than the class-based shows, class-targeted shows? Indian audiences in rural areas will not take kindly to the profanities, and I'm not saying that you need censorship. What I'm saying is, will they have to move towards more family-oriented content as we go forward? If they want to build a very robust ecosystem, robust number of subscribers, robust advertising spends on their OTT platforms. Copying the West is not the only way to work in India. Television learned this the very hard way. Foreign content doesn't work. The English genre has almost lost all its audiences after the new tariff order was brought out by the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. The audiences have dropped drastically. So the sensibilities, Indian cultural sensibilities, have to be borne in mind when you're making in content in India. Mirzapur, Sacred Games, Four More Shots Please, Rangbaz, they may work with certain set of audiences, but you need more massy-oriented shows which are more family-targeted to give audiences in the interiors another option for viewing. Otherwise, you'll remain a niche service with, let's say, 10 million, 5 million, 8 million, 10 million subscribers. Is that enough to build robust businesses? You also have to have the Indian the Indian consumer is a different beast. So how do you make the experience on OTT for the Indians very, very friendly for them? Can you have audio interactivity with the OTT service? That's another thing the Indian OTT players have to ponder over. We at IndianTelevision.com don't think we've really scratched the surfaces of the OTT. One second, I've lost something. I'll use this. We believe we barely scratched the surface of what opportunities lie in OTT. We are at the beginning of the OTT explosion, something like we were in the 90s, way back when satellite television hit India. So I expect a lot of niche OTTs to come up as we go forward. I expect a lot of publishers, newspaper publishers, and other production houses and creators to set up niche OTTs. We've already seen examples of that with Dice Media, Array, coming up with very, very niche. We've seen Hoi Choi. We've seen on the other side, there's a company called Adda Times in Kolkata. So we're going to see smaller OTTs coming up, catering to niche audiences. We've got another one called MyNK coming up, Mink, which is targeting independent films. And it's got on the back end, it's got blockchain in terms of dealing with consumer payments, etc. So also, what plagues the industry is piracy. There's a show launched on Amazon, a few days later it's not even sometimes, yeah, a few days later it's on a torrent site, you can watch it for free. So why should I pay for Amazon? And then the sharing of accounts is another issue which is plaguing the industry. We'll find solutions. But it's a journey. We've just begun the OTT revolution now. From my side, that was a few thoughts I wanted to put forward as the conference begins. We welcome you to Vidnet and make the day very interactive. Ask questions. Feel free. This is your platform. Learn from the people who are running these, during challenging times, they're running OTT services. Make it interactive. Let us all ride this journey and let us make a huge success of OTT as we go forward. Thank you very much, and let's have a great day. Let's have fantastic sessions today.